All right, guys. So I have Andrew Henderson here. I am so excited. I've been wanting to get this guy on my channel for about 48 years now because I live in California. I've been trying to escape for 48 years. So he is the Nomad Capitalist, and I'm just super excited. Andrew, if there's something that you want to say before I start rattling off the questions and my stupidity, go for it.
Well, no, I'm a big fan of your channel. It's great to talk about, people don't know that the hidden green room secrets, talking about purses, talking about perfumes, but I'm very impressed because I love everything that you're doing and I'm glad to be with you. So
now everyone needs to know, what are you saying? Okay. We were talking about my colognes. So one of them is Oud Wood. These are, I call them my panty dropper. Actually, this one's the panty dropper.
That one, you know.
Yeah. This one's the panty dropper. This is a perfume de Marley. There is no plug. There is no link in the description. So we were just chatting. So now tell me, Andrew, in regards to my stupidity, I currently live in California. I have been trying to exit this shat hole for about a year and a half now because my audience says I have to leave. Not because there's free housing everywhere all over the streets. You just kind of bring your own tent. But tell me, What do you think in regards to leaving California and what they're going to do to me if I stay or if you decide to visit here?
Well, California, it's got to be the worst. I talk to people from all over the world. We work with a lot of Americans, but we also work with Brazilians. We work with Russians. We work with Malay. We work with people from all over the place. You look at tax collection agencies, the franchise tax board, and I spent 6 months in California. It felt like a decade. And I had, it was a decade practically of dealing with them not receiving the taxes that I sent for my 6 months and hounding me and levying bank accounts. And I had to call them and say, here's the canceled check and everything else. They are the most aggressive. I mean, they are more aggressive than the FSB when it comes to collecting money. And so what have we seen? I don't like to be an alarmist as some people are, but you know, when I hear enough things, you know, when someone comes to me and they say New Zealand 18 times in the first 30 minutes, I'm like, I think this guy wants to go to New Zealand. I probably shouldn't argue with him. When you hear from the California Assembly, they had the wealth tax. It failed last year. Now they wanted to have another wealth tax. Now they're even talking about if you've spent 60 days in California, for whatever reason, they're going to try and go back and for the next decade, apply some kind of proportional wealth tax. So, you know, if you're the sheik's daughters coming over from Abu Dhabi and you spend 90 days for the summer, you know, sunning your buns on the beach, now for the next 10 years, they're going to say, all right, you know, 90 days divided by whatever, you know, send us X percent of your wealth. And people say, well, how are they going to do that? Well, the same way that I lived in an entirely different part of the U.S. and they helped themselves to my bank account. People seem to like being in bed with California. And so I just think, you know, we've seen these people doing crazy stuff for how many? I mean, I was there in 2007. It was crazy. Now it's even crazy. Like, they want to be crazy. It's not going to get any better. And I just kind of think, you know, why wait for them to finally figure out what's going to work in terms of nailing you to the wall and taking all of your money? That's what they want to do.
All right, guys. And for those of you that, sorry, I had to cut Andrew off because I bought his book and I actually got the, I did not get the paperback. I'm sorry, Andrew. I went a little cheap. I got the Kindle and I was looking for an audio because I'm such an audio guy. When is the audio? Are you going to be doing that anytime soon?
This is probably one of the most asked questions. And I'll tell you the honest truth. I got the best microphone. I mean, I said, spend whatever it takes, get the best microphone. And then I went to my home in Montenegro and I left it there. And then everyone who's been there since and has come to meet me has forgotten to bring the microphone. So it's kind of been, but we're going to actually be touching up the book just with a few, you know, updates. And this is the book. You can get it on Amazon. And I will be rolling out an audio hopefully in a couple months.
Okay. Well, if you want
hundreds of people,
I can go ahead and I can do the audio for you. If you want, I can be like, hey guys, so, I'm Andrew here. Also, guys, he has a website, so go take a look. He's way more popular than I am, as you can see by Forbes, wow. CNN, Money, Fox, all this. And he also wears very sexy scarves that I'm slightly jealous of, the Louis Vuitton scarf, which I had discussed earlier. So make sure you guys buy his book like I did and take a look at his site. So now let me ask you, Can you give me some advice for a stupid Californian? What would be my baby steps? Number one, don't visit California. You'll be very unimpressed. But baby steps that I can take to get out of here.
The first part, just you mentioned don't visit California, that knowing that there are so many other places that have what you want. I mean, when I talk to people who are in California, they say we love the beaches, we love the girls in bikinis, we like the restaurants. Believe me, there's beaches wherever you want to go. There's thousands of beaches all over the world, including we put out something called the Nomad Beach Index a couple of years ago, where we ranked the most tax-friendly places to live with nice beaches. So if you're in California, the baby step, I suppose, is you move to Nevada, you move to Florida, you move to Texas. I guess they have beaches in some of those places. You know, what I've said is my five magic words are go where you're treated best. And so for me, you know, you're in California, you're paying 13% tax, the highest bracket. They want to make it 16% tax. So now if you're self-employed, you're paying payroll tax, you have, you know, lower SALT deductions, you have, you know, federal, I mean, you're paying over half. Maybe you move to Florida, you're Grant Cardone, or you move to Nashville, you're Ben Shapiro, or Texas, you know, Joe Rogan. Maybe you're paying 44% now. To me, the baby step is Puerto Rico, and you're going to pay something like 4% on your income, and you're going to spend at least half the year in Puerto Rico. And I think a lot of people do that because they don't feel comfortable leaving the U.S. There's this kind of sense of security, knowing that you're kind of within the U.S. territory in Puerto Rico. You get the tax savings. You don't have to give up your citizenship, which people don't realize. You don't have to give up your citizenship to live overseas and reduce your taxes. But Puerto Rico, to me, is the baby step, because rather than paying 44, you can pay 4. You know, for me, it's like that old Seinfeld bit where he says, why doesn't the plane just fly as fast as possible? And I say, if you're going to move, if you're packing up the truck, if the kids are saying goodbye to their friends, you know, if you're leaving your favorite brekkie place, just you might as well put the pedal to the metal and at least get it down to 4% to start.
I agree. My friend Mark Moss, who I've had on this channel. Yep, that's where he went. And so he's like, yeah, the surf's great. Well, come on out. Like, man. So yeah, my step was Texas. That's where I'm building in Texas on the lakes. I need water. But I'm thinking, okay, so maybe Puerto Rico. And then from Puerto Rico, what would be the next? That's my first baby. Well, Texas was my first baby set. And also I'm getting destroyed in taxes. Because ever since 2007, everything that I've done has been two things. One, either digital, or it's been passive income. That's it. I figured out a long time ago not to get a job. Jobs, no. I'm a high school business teacher. I figured that one out. Now everything's passive and digital, so I can go to Puerto Rico and I'm fine. Even teaching high school, if they would let me, I'd still do it. So after Puerto Rico, what would be the next little baby step?
Well, here's the beautiful thing. There are over 200 countries and territories out there to choose from. And so, you know, maybe you like the idea of the Cayman Islands. Maybe you're like me. You like places like Malaysia. You like the Asian influence. I'm in Colombia right now. I think it's, you know, a great place to spend part of the year. One of the things that I've done is I've developed something called the trifecta method, where from a lifestyle perspective, but also in some cases from a tax perspective, you spend 4 months of the year in three different places. And so right now I'm in Colombia. I'm loving the great vibes. I'm loving the, you know, the food, and just it's exciting. The greenery here, people wouldn't imagine that Bogota is as beautiful as it is. I also like going to Asia, consumer paradise. You know, if you want to go in and get that loop, you know, that giant vat of Tom Ford, they got plenty of Tom Ford stores there that you can swing a dead cat and hit three of them. You know, so you have the consumer convenience. People speak English in places like Malaysia. You know, it's the future. It's modern. And then I like to spend a little bit of time in Europe. And so you can do that in certain countries. As an American, it's more difficult for sure because of all the laws that follow you no matter where you go as a citizen. You know, but I like the idea of splitting up my time because I can't imagine spending the entire year in Colombia, but I love spending part of the year here. And I think that every place has something to offer. And so you can pick 1, 2, 3, 6. I got one guy, he has 6 places all around the world. He wants to spend 2 months in each. And then he travels from there 1 week every for the 2 months. You know, he's in Thailand, he goes to Myanmar. So I think you can create whatever lifestyle you want, but you have to go back to understanding that, you know, they've got pretty good beaches, even in Cambodia, for example. No one would think that, but, you know, better than California maybe.
Now let's talk about taxes. Because what people don't understand is this isn't going to get any better. I just dodged a bullet right by my ear in California, where it's the property tax. And I don't know who in their right mind is like, yeah, you know what? We need to have huge, we got, you know, tax rates up the wazoo. We're almost 15%. Why not just, you know, go after property? I know that's what's going to happen. So I'm like, I got to get out of here before this thing goes. All right. So what do I need?
You dodged a bullet.
What do I need to do about all these taxes that, I mean, they're not going to be going down. They will be going up. So please tell my audience that there's no way. So go ahead.
Well, you know, it's interesting. I just mentioned Malaysia. I've seen more countries. I've got a team. We do strategy. We read the most boring tax journals you've ever seen. That's what we do. Because we help people plan taxes is one of our things. I don't think I've ever seen more publicity for a wealth tax in the wake of COVID than any other tax that we've looked at. There are so many countries. I saw it even the other day, New Zealand, which prides itself on among the big English-speaking countries. They have a high income tax relatively, but they don't have all the other taxes. And even now, people there are talking about it. And so they're going to roll out new taxes. I saw that in Minnesota, the governor wants a wealth tax there. California has talked about it. Other states have talked about it. I saw a mansion tax. They want to have a mansion tax in Connecticut now. But yet you go to Malaysia, for example, and they said, hey, are you going to have a wealth tax to pay for COVID? And they said, no, we tried that. It didn't work. So did some European countries that have high taxes. I saw a thing today. Indonesia plans to lower taxes. So my perspective is you have Western countries, which I've basically called legacy brands, right? They're brands that they built themselves up and people are buying them for the brand name. They're staying there for the brand name. They're staying there because the United States is the best country on earth, even though I've never been anywhere else. It's funny. I woke up two Saturdays ago. I was on Russian TV on like the propaganda channel. And they said, look at this guy who gave up his U.S. citizenship. All the Americans are moving to Russia. Our country is so great. I never moved to Russia. And so, you know, they have the same thing going on there. What's the best country in the world, right? And so the legacy brands, because they have you suckered in, they're going to raise your income tax. They're going to raise capital gains tax. Biden wants to do that. Now he can. They're going to impose wealth taxes in some places. I told Robert Kiyosaki, I said, I think you're going to see retroactive taxes. You saw it 3 years ago in the U.S. for expats who had companies overseas. They had to go back 31 years and pay a one-time tax. You have now in the UK, they're saying, if you leave, but you don't leave soon enough, we're going to go back and ring you in to whatever tax we pass in the future. So I think not only are the tax rates going to go up on income, capital gains, they're going to try and do things to cryptocurrency. But I also think that they're going to make up new tax. I mean, a mansion tax.
Yeah, I mean, even the crypto. And that's so sad. It's like, leave me alone. Can I just have currency? And I need to do a real quick plug. For those of you that are watching this, I'm going to throw out some kind of Nomad discount on both of these courses. These two, the Dominate Stocks and the Dominate Amazon. Now, again, selling on Amazon, this is passive income and it's digital. Start a course, don't start a course, sell a product. Well, actually, I mean, Andrew sells a book. It's digital and it's passive. So I'm going to offer a killer discount on that. And then with that said money, what do? You trade equities. So I'll give you a discount on both of those. And I'll also split up the payment just for my audience. So link in the description on that, because whenever I have people on, I don't do anything. I'm like, I got zero.
That's the thing that people, by the way, when I just talked to someone before we spoke and I said, what are you paying? They said, we're paying, two and a quarter a year. I said, okay, what would you do with that two and a quarter a year? They said, well, we'd invest it. I said, what's your track record on the investing? 9-10%. Okay. That's an extra $22,000 a year. Every year they're adding to the recurring pot, right? And so this tax thing, it's the biggest opportunity cost. If you're selling on Amazon, I've had so many guys who sell on Amazon. I say, what do you do with the money you save by going from 54 or 44 to 4? And they're like, I'd put it back into creating new products. And here's the reality. There's a guy who's already paying for, who's looking to pour boiling oil over your head as his competitor, because he can put more of his money back into product, whereas you're scrounging around looking for tax deductions on December 28th, trying to, save a few pennies. You're not focused on growing the business because you're focused too much on tax.
I wish I wouldn't, but I kind of have to be. And then did we already talk about how the government is going to be stopping, or what do you think the government will be do when it comes to the U.S. citizens to stopping us from actually leaving?
Well, you know, I remember, and again, I think some people maybe take it too far, but I mean, I remember watching Ron Paul in the Republican presidential debate 8 or 9 years ago saying, you know, you guys want a wall? Walls can keep people in too. Maybe it was 4 years ago, but when Trump was talking about the wall, but you know, he said, hey, walls can keep people in too. And so you look at the United States, they're basically the only country in the world. China's starting, South Africa's starting, but not as big as the US. They're effectively the only country in the world that taxes citizens the same overseas as if they were in the US. Now, you get an exemption or an exclusion on your salary. If you're married, you can both take a salary. You know, if you're running a business, you can defer a lot of that. You can still reduce your rate. But, you know, for folks who have passive income like crypto, who are trading stocks, I've got day traders, it's very hard to defer as an American. So they can live wherever they want. They're going to pay full boat tax. And so their path is, you know what? I'm just handing in my passport. I'm out of here. I'm divorcing the country. I'm going to go to one of those other 200 places in the world that will treat me best. And guess what they've done since COVID? You can't make an appointment to do that almost anywhere. So basically, and by the way, if you have $2 million or more when you do expatriate, now you're subject to a tax if you've sold everything. I had a guy who had a big business that eventually went public, and now he's just going to pay the tax. But had he expatriated when he first came to me a couple of years ago, he had a company valued at a couple $100 million. He doesn't have the cash to pay the capital gains tax on that, but they would apply the tax when he left. And so imagine someone's trying to leave before they accumulate too much money, right? And that's the government. You have too much money. I saw some country, I think it was Canada, they're talking about an excess profits tax. You make too much money. Did you ever think in the capitalist world, you make too much money? But now they won't even let you leave the system. Australia, you can't leave the country. There are some exceptions. And perhaps if you're moving overseas, you know, you can convince them. But, you know, what a perfect excuse. And there's always an excuse, right?
No, for everything. The government, everything, there's an excuse. Now, to wrap this all up, how bad do you see, as if it, to me, it's horrible. I pay my tax bill and you'll go, wow, because I pay my fair share. Ugh, how bad do you see it getting?
First of all, let's put it in perspective. You know, I remember first paying attention to this end of the Clinton era, beginning of Bush 43 era in the United States. I was a teenage libertarian, and it always sounds better in theory, right? Until you start actually paying the taxes, then you get a lot angrier. But I remember Bush lowered taxes to 35% at the federal level from 39.6. And people acted like they just moved to Dubai or something. Right? Trump took it down to 37. And people said, oh, I'm doing great with Trump. He lowered your taxes 2.6%. Okay, let's not get too carried away. And so if they go back up to 39.6, is that going to be the end of the world? The problem is, if you're living in a Western country, you're paying too much. They're nickeling and diming you on new taxes. You're paying a lot for just, you know, everyday stuff. I think, you know, I think the worst part in the US is going to be potentially not only a wealth tax in some places, potentially a retroactive tax. But also the payroll tax. They want to take the cap off over 400 grand. Remember, Bill Clinton did that on Medicare back in the 90s, where it's if you're self-employed, it's about 2.9% on every dollar you make. And so now the argument is, because the culture has changed even worse since Bill Clinton, to where, I mean, I saw an AOC tweet earlier today. The entire thing was, tax the rich. That's all she has to say. Like, there's no act. There's no nuance. There's no, let me explain. It's just tech. Oh, that's great. And so, you know, there's such a societal demand just to take. And so they'll say, oh, you made 10 million bucks from your Amazon business. Pay full self-employment on that. Are you going to get a check for 27 grand a month passive income when you hit Social Security age? Of course not. It's going to go for all the money that they've squandered. So I think that, you know, potentially if you're self-employed, there's an extra 12% in change right there on top of whatever else they can dream up. You said rising property taxes. They will use this as an excuse. 9/11 was to security, but this will be for taxes. And I am seeing it. And the good news is they've spent decades lubricating the public to hate the rich. People don't understand. 9 out of 10 North Americans who are millionaires didn't inherit anything, but doesn't matter. They say, hey, if we just took all of Jeff Bezos' money, that would pay for the vaccines, as if that makes sense.
Right. And even like with me, with my baby step is just to avoid the almost 15% that I'm getting hit. And just because I live in this lovely state of California with an amazing governor and, you know, the politicians, they're just all so sweet to us. So I'm just going over that way. No people from Texas. I don't carry California politics over there. Andrew, go ahead and wrap us up. Anything that you would like to say? And I just want to say thank you so much for coming on, by the way. I really appreciate it.
Well, I appreciate you having me. I mean, here's the thing that I've said, right? I think I've tried to set an example for people in my life and hopefully for all of our subscribers on YouTube, everyone who reads the book, reads the website, you know, really proud of it, 17 million people last year. And what I try and do by example is saying, you can live in Colombia, you're not going to be murdered. You can live in Malaysia, you're going to have a nice life, maybe a better life, especially for all the people who are single out there watching. If you're living in California, probably going to find a lot more hospitable dating scene in a lot of these places. And so, you know, you have to be aware of go where you're treated best. If you look at statistics, the US is number one in nothing except for prisoners per capita. And you can talk about police states all you want. There's more people in you know, than any other country. People want to, I saw Hong Kong in the news. I saw Belarus in the news. There's a lot more people in prison in the US. Everything else, banks during the recession, 40th safest. Healthcare system, 37th best. We did the Nomad Passport Index 4 years in a row, 35th best passport in the world. Now, it's not last, but why are you settling for kind of sort of okay when you could settle for best? And so my message is, maybe you live in one country, you have a business incorporated in another with your Amazon business, you know, you trade stocks in another country that treats you better than US stocks. You know, have a citizenship in another country, you know, your wife is from another country. I mean, whatever, just, you know, cherry pick from the buffet, right? There's no one country that's gonna satisfy all of those things. You look at a place like Singapore, what a great place to store wealth. For me, as someone who has the freedom that you're talking about creating with your courses, you know, I would not choose to live in a place where to buy the house I want, it costs $5 million. I can go to Malaysia, people are a little more relaxed, and it costs $500,000. And for me, it's even nicer to have a little bit of grit, a little bit of, you know, interesting things going on. And so, you know, am I going to incorporate in Malaysia? Probably not. Am I going to keep all my money in Malaysia? Probably not. Am I going to get a Malaysian citizenship? No. Next to impossible. But cherry pick from that buffet. Go where you're treated best. Ask yourself in any transaction. You wouldn't go to a sushi restaurant that was 3 out of 5 stars. If you went on Yelp and the sushi restaurant had 3 stars, you'd be like, I'm going to the next place. We're having chicken tonight. But somehow we accept 3 out of 5 stars. I mean, California, what would that Yelp rating be for a rich guy like you? A nasty, disgusting rich guy like you.
It would be in the comments section. It would just be all like, if I could give this a negative.
Negatives.
One, right. It would be.
Zero place. Stars is too good for this dump.
And it's sad too, me being I'm a teacher. But then, you know, all of my companies and businesses, because I figured out early on, if I want to be wealthy, if I want to be able to go to Malaysia, if I wanted to, I can't be a teacher. I have to own companies. And I beat that in everyone's head that come onto my channel. Two things, copy the 1%, copy the rich, start businesses, trade equities. That's it.
Well, right. So that is the baby step. If people still have a job, you need to find a way to make it portable. Now, I have folks, you know, from time to time, they can, you know, do it. I had a gentleman, his wife's a radiologist. He can do that anywhere in the world. Apparently you can look at x-rays, what have you, but, you know, have something you can take with you and ideally have something that you can choose your own tax rate. If you're working for a company, maybe harder, even if you're working remote, if you are, you know, in total control of your business, now you have control of the tax code and the US tax code, much more flexible for entrepreneurs who go overseas. I've got a friend, he's a big guy in the banking business, multi-million dollar salary. He just pays and pays and pays. Doesn't matter he lives in a zero tax country because he's an American. Whereas if he could incorporate that into a business, at least he would be paying a heck of a lot less. And if he weren't an American, he could be paying zero. But you have to be portable.
Well, how about this? Just so I don't feel so bad, is there a place rather than Los Angeles, California, with all that I have that I could be paying more?
Oh, yeah. We have guys from Norway, from Sweden, Denmark. We have some folks who are looking to go and visit their family. They have a daughter in Denmark. And I'm saying, like, they're in California. I'm saying, like, that might be, like, the one worst place on earth to go. I was in Sweden, God, I don't know, 5 years ago. And the train was a couple minutes late. And I was kind of joking with the guy on the platform. I said, like, you know, you guys have this figured out. You have such high taxes. I thought everything was perfect. He said, oh, you wouldn't believe. We just lowered the tax rate from 59 to 55, and now everything's nothing's working anymore. By the way, we're seeing that right now all around the world. I mean, what are the headlines? The UK, the US, all these countries, especially the ones that have, you know, socialized medicine, that's supposed to be the great pride of society, and that's fine. We're at capacity. We got to lock you down. You got to stay home because we don't have any room. Excuse me. I'm giving you people, Boris Johnson today said, oh, I want to apologize to everyone. We didn't do this quite right. I'm giving you half my money and you didn't do it quite right. I mean, if I had a business partner who I was giving 47% equity to and he's sitting around in the corner making a bunch of mistakes, he's out. How do I get rid of this guy? But you can't get rid of Boris. You can't get rid of Joe Biden. You're stuck at the hip with them. And yet when the time comes, when people were stuck at the beginning of COVID and they called the U.S. Embassy, yeah, I don't know. We might arrange a private jet. You know, it's 20 grand a person. If you want to hop on board, let us know. We'll send you a bill. Excuse me. What have I been paying for my entire life? I thought this was the service I was paying for. No, no. You're just paying for wars and now you don't get anything.
Well, yeah, I guess. And the good news is it's only going to get worse, kids. So start figuring it out now. And if you haven't yet figured it out, figure it out. Andrew, thank you so much for coming on the channel. And for all of you, make sure you go, you know, he has a YouTube channel, so go subscribe. He does more videos than me. So this guy's grinding it out. So again, Andrew, thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you for having me. Great pleasure to be with you.